Kuala Lumpur, the capital of Malaysia, has undergone a remarkable transformation in recent decades, characterized by a skyscraper boom that has elevated the country's urban landscape to new heights. The proliferation of towering structures has not only become a symbol of Malaysia's rapid development, but has also brought about economic, social, and architectural changes in the country. Kuala Lumpur is also one of the fastest-growing metropolitan regions in Southeast Asia, having transformed from a small tin mining town in the 1800s to a thriving center of culture and commerce. The Petronas Twin Towers, completed in 1998, is the crown jewel of Kuala Lumpur's skyscraper boom. The towers were the world's tallest building at one point in time, but as the years went by, the tower lost its title to many other megastructures around the world. Now Kuala Lumpur is evolving again, as there is a new tower on the block that will put Malaysia back on the record holders list. Construction is nearly complete on what will be the second tallest building in the world, and possibly the world's last megatall skyscraper. In today's video, we will explore this remarkable construction that is set to revive the Kuala Lumpur skyline. Before we get started, don't forget to click on that subscribe button and leave a comment, as it's the best way to help us grow as a channel. Merdeka 118 Tower, standing at a height of 678.9 meters, is Malaysia's latest mega construction. It has a multifaceted diamond-shaped facade and unique spire design. The skyscraper is classed by the Council on Tall Buildings and Urban Habitat as a megatall, a building that is over 600 meters in height. It is scheduled for completion by June 2023, and it will also become the tallest skyscraper in Southeast Asia. Merdeka 118 will be 192 meters taller than the current Kuala Lumpur title holder, the Petronas Twin Towers. They were the tallest buildings in the world from 1998 to 2004 and the first buildings to hold the title outside the US. Merdeka Tower steals the title of the world's second tallest building from the Shanghai Tower in China, which is at a height of 632 meters. Only the Burj Khalifa in Dubai, at 830 meters, stands taller than this new skyscraper. This mega project is expected to cost about $1.5 billion, and construction of the tower is around 95% complete as of today, with its opening scheduled for 2024. This development is one of the largest projects ever undertaken in Malaysia. Even though there is little need for buildings of such extreme height, they often serve more as status symbols than responses to a demand for commercial or residential space. Likewise, Merdeka Tower was built to signify Malaysia's eminence. Construction of Merdeka Tower began in 2016 on a site overlooking Stadium Merdeka, a historically significant site built for Malaysia. It is at this stadium that Malaysia's independence from the British was first announced. The shape of the glass and steel building, together with its spire, was inspired by and built to resemble the silhouette of Malaysia's first Prime Minister Tunku Abdul Rahman raising his hand while chanting Merdeka and proclaiming the country's independence on August 31, 1957. The Malay term Merdeka means independent, therefore the tower is a tribute to the country's independence. The tower symbolizes the union of the historic and contemporary, and it will be the new focal point on the striking skyline of Malaysia's capital city. Merdeka Tower has been completed by Australian design studio Fender Katsalidis in collaboration with local architectural firms of RSP and GDP, and engineering firms Robert Bird Group and Lira. PNB, one of Malaysia's leading investment firms, has funded the construction of this skyscraper. The designs of this building were influenced by Malaysian culture. Recognizing that Malaysia is a multicultural society, the diversity of triangular designs that make up the structure represent the various ethnic groups that inhabit the country. This iconic tower is designed with a mixture of diamond-shaped facets derived from a traditional Malay songket pattern, celebrating the cultural diversity and traditional legacy of Malaysia. The building's cladding will comprise 18,000 panels, 114,000 square meters of glass, and 1,600 tons of window frame extrusions. The building will be equipped and illuminated at night with 8.4 kilometers of LED light strips, which would gradually move from one corner to another. The spire, rising to more than 160 meters, brings Merdeka to a total height of 678.9 meters, thus claiming to be the tallest building in Malaysia and the second tallest building in the world. The building will also be the first in Malaysia to receive a triple platinum rating from worldwide sustainability certifications, including the Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design. Merdeka Tower will be mixed use, with residential, retail, and office space. The figure 118 represents the number of floors in the building. Spanning over 3.1 million square feet of floor area, the Merdeka Tower includes 1.7 million square feet of net lettable area of premium Grade A rentable office space. The top 17 floors will house the first and only Park Hyatt Hotel in Malaysia, with approximately 250 guest rooms and suites that are designed to embrace the unparalleled sweeping views of the city skyline. The hotel will offer approximately 1,850 square meters of meeting space for conferences and events. A giant mall will be located on the tower's lower floors, providing space for more than 328 stores. According to reports, 70% of the skyscraper will be occupied by local companies, and the remaining 30% will be occupied by multinational companies. It will be home to the headquarters for PNB, the building's owner and developer. A must-visit attraction at the Merdeka 118 Tower will be at level 116, where Southeast Asia's highest observation deck is located. A large underground station connecting several of Kuala Lumpur's LRT and MRT lines is being built in the tower's basement levels so that the building could be integrated with all the rail networks in the city. In addition, Merdeka Tower sits within a 4-acre linear water park with associated public open spaces. It is a car-free recreational area designed to promote vibrant community interaction within the city. The race to build the world's tallest skyscraper never ends, with more and more impressive heights reached. Following the completion of the Burj Khalifa in 2010, it was anticipated that the world has entered the era of the megatall, and by 2020, around 10 new buildings would lay claim to this title. Several proposals for megatall skyscrapers were put forward since then, and construction began on some of them. But fast forward to today, only one other megatall skyscraper has been completed, which is the Shanghai Tower, standing 632 meters tall. Some of the proposed megatall skyscrapers are SkyMile Tower in Japan, Oblisco Capitale in Egypt, and Dubai One Tower. There are two other megatall skyscrapers that began construction, Saudi Arabia's Jeddah Tower and Dubai Creek Tower. Jeddah Tower is planned to be the first 1 kilometer high building in the world. Construction on the project began in 2013 and there was steady progress, but in 2018, work came to a halt when the tower was about one-third complete. Nearly 10 years later, the project is all but dead. Meanwhile, construction work on the 1,300 meters tall Dubai Creek Tower started in October 2016. When Saudi Arabia announced the construction of Jeddah Tower, it would have taken the title of world's tallest building away from Dubai. Soon after, Dubai began constructing the Creek Tower so that the prestigious title could be retained. Unfortunately, construction of Creek Tower was also put on hold. As of today, it is uncertain if or when these two projects will be finished. Meanwhile, Kuwait has announced that it would begin construction on what could become the world's tallest building. Known as Burj Mubarak Al Kabir, the skyscraper will be 1 kilometer tall, precisely 1,001 meters, and construction is anticipated to start in 2023. This skyscraper is part of Kuwait's vast Silk City development that is currently ongoing, and the project, including the skyscraper, will take more than 25 years to be completed. By 2023, Malaysia's Merdeka Tower will rise as the world's last megatall skyscraper, and for many years to come, there won't be another skyscraper to rival Merdeka. What are your thoughts on this mega construction? Let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.